Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Baldur's Gate. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today we'll be reading the Recipes and Ruminations of One Dradeel of Tethyr. Formerly, a lovely bun cake brightens anyone's day. The recipes herein are mine own imagining, and thus ingredients are subject to change as per my whim. Belladonna Bun Cake. A simple little dish for a rainy afternoon. Corn flour, the eggs of a seabird, a spoon of the white cap fungus, the fruit of your choice for sweetening, one small measure of the belladonna root. Prepare as one would a bread loaf, though less time given to the rising. Bake in a well-stoked hearth under leaves for one turn of the hourglass. Notes to myself, refrain from eating this ever again. Exceptionally poisonous. Remember the unfortunate week on the kitchen floor. Dradeel's Vegetable Surprise. A dish that turned out surprisingly edible. Not recommended as the primary meal every day for 300 years. Some disorientation may result. Place 2 cups of virgin Netherese olive oil and 1 large chopped onion in a large pot. Sauté onions in oil over medium fire until onions begin to become clear. Add 2 chopped carrots and 2 chopped stalks of celery. Sauté for an additional 3 minutes. Add 1.5 quarts of water and bring to a boil. Add 2 diced and peeled potatoes. 1 cup of white wine. I find that a Mithrinian vintage is perfect. 1 bay leaf, 2 diced tomatoes, and chopped parsley to taste. Cook covered over medium-smallish fire until vegetables are almost tender. Add 2 cups of chopped spinach and cook for an additional 15 minutes. Serve hot and garnish with grated cheese. Note, for orcish version, replace all ingredients with turnips. Curative ingredients for the dispelling of lycanthropy. Mother's family recipe. Notes, Mother's topical salve is a rather large failure. Research further with the following in mind. The creatures on this isle are unusual beyond their splitting into 2 factions. Theirs is an odd curse, one that defies the traditional remedies, such as the unfortunately dangerous muffins previous. Though one is not without hope, the exotic origin of the original stock suggests a unique enchantment not unlike that of the more widely known vampiric afflictions. The casual bite might be averted using such things as the belladonna flower, but an intentional infection could actually require the extermination of the leader of the clan. This is merely conjecture, of course, as I have been unable to examine said leader. Despite my strange immunity, his is a strength that could still inflict a measure of serious damage upon my physical form. He and I have spoken on occasion, though his tolerance of me is no more resilient than mine of him. Further notes to myself. Future offerings of peace to either of the Wolven clans should not take the form of muffins of any sort. The Bachelor's Crutch. Noodles of quality and convenience. Ingredients. A measure of noodles. Boiling water. Container. Combine ingredients in container. Enjoy. Oh yes, enjoy. Notes to myself. Should probably be supplemented with something of nutritional value, lest my bones become brittle as chalk. Perhaps the container? Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Baldur's Gate, The Recipes and Ruminations of One Dradeel of Tethyr.